brought to you in part by St. Croix Rods, fish with a legend. Arden, rule the water. Strike King Lure Company, gearing up champions for over 40 years.
This week on Extreme Angler.
That's what I call great, big, fat bass.
This week on the Cottage Angler, I'm going to show you how to fish a tree. A tree that's sloping to deeper water.
We'll be right back.
Okay, early bass season. Where do you go? What do you do? What I'm gonna do first is fish shallow, okay? This is a weekend, a lot of people around spooking those fish off, so I'm gonna try to fish those little isolated spots, little bushes, overhanging trees, sunken timber, things where I think those fish got pushed off of those docks. I'm gonna fish with plastics, with jigs. Again, fairly shallow, probably from 5 feet to maybe a foot deep, and try to find those fish and get those reaction strikes. I'm putting it in those little zones where they are. They come out, eat it. Let's see if we can get some big fat bass for you folks. Let's do it. First spot, gotta go with the jig, okay? Like I said, I'm gonna go to spots where the fish, it's all reaction strike. Real shallow, real high impact, one-on-one. So the jig, I'm gonna put it in certain spots like small clumps. Again, real shallow, 5 feet and less, clumps. Sunken logs, the end of logs. We're gonna see if those fish are active and wanna eat. Let's see if we can get it done. What I'm looking for, isolated logs, small weed patches and stuff like that. So Polaroid glasses, they are a must. Not maybe, should I wear them? I've got some cheaper stuff. Believe me, invest in good sunglasses, you can't go wrong. Because man, you'll see fish flare. But the biggest thing is I'm just looking for slight shadows of the wood, a little bit of edges of weed, etc. Okay, the water is pretty clear here, but you can see things at a distance and then throw to it. Here's another thing about the shallow water stuff. Trolling motor, I got it real low. Like I mean, turn right down. A lot of times, if I see areas that I like, I'll get close, turn it down, glide in real slow, have the speed set at an area where I can just slowly putt and glide. Go and glide. Don't zoom into your spots. It does nothing. If you gotta turn around and blow out an area, good luck catching fish. So sometimes turn the trolling motor down, work an area if you believe there's fish, slow down, you'll catch more fish. On wood and weed, a solid fish. Solid, not a big one, just solid. Right to the top, so you know you grabbed it good. Fat little bass, still not what we're looking for. But they're getting your heart going. Fat little guys. Hey boy, go on, get out of there. So that just shows me that they are in the mood to grab it. So let's just keep going. Look at this. This is the stuff right here I'm talking about, right here. This, these overhanging bushes, away from the docks, natural cover, nature's cover right here. And that's what the fish hold to. Gotta get it right back underneath there. Let them grab it. The best thing about this kind of stuff is they can't go that way. They have to come out. Now look at this out here. A tree has fallen in winter and got dragged out by the ice. And it's about 50 feet offshore. Let's see if somebody found it. Somebody called bass. Nice, a gift, a spot like that. Big fish is gonna find that one day. Guarantee ya. Oh, there's a log in front of me. Right here. It's a good one. Not a giant. A solid fish. Sitting on the wood. Oh, he's not a giant at all. Just a solid little fish. Look at him. He grabbed it. Just felt that little spongy weight. With these little baits, like I said, they're not gonna spit it out. Give them some time, and they will get hooked. Look at that, just a solid little buck bass. No giant, go on. We're looking for a giant. All I found here was just some trees, logs, no docks around here. Nature's cover. We're gonna keep doing it. Here's where you gotta check everything, seriously. I don't know, stickler for that, you hear it all the time, but boy, I make sure if they rub on wood, you never know if there's even mussels and stuff. Check the point. It's very important. Always look down your barb. You take hooks out of fish's mouth sometimes. You bend the barb, so. Looks good to me. Keep at it. Subtle things. Like a single log. A little sparse patch of weed. Oh, there comes some logs. Oh, boy. If you put those two together, logs with weed, shallow water, look out. It can be real scary, man. Actually, there's a little bit of depth change here too, from 2 feet to 5. Boy, oh boy. That's a recipe for big fish. Get ready. Big piece of wood right here, man. Sticking up. Here comes the pitch, my friends. Here we go. See? Told ya. You find the right wood. Find the bass. Come here, you. Oh, just a solid fish, not a giant. Solid, fat bass. See? Like I said, look where I got him too. Oh, that's why you gotta keep tension on, man. Oh, just barely lifted out. But again, solid fish. Not a giant, hiding in the wood. Working around, slow, slow, slow. Getting the right spot, out he comes. You wait to feel the fish, then hit him. I'll tell you folks something about nothing looking water. What I call nothing looking water is the stuff between docks, okay? Pads, arrowheads, grass, milfoil, cabbage, wood, even rock. It's the stuff between man-made cover that holds bass. A lot of guys pass up. So you see sometimes just a little bit of mat. That's all it is. A little piece, just something a bass can hold onto. So sometimes I go along the shoreline, I'll hit the wood along the edges, and I'll look. Good sunglasses, and I see the different things, structure elements. I've got that belief that when those fish get spooked off the dock, they'll go and they'll stay for a while. When they get comfortable again, either go to the dock or another spot. When they get spooked off, they'll still bite, believe me. They don't have got a real short memory. So keep that in mind sometimes. Look around, try fish the different stuff. When you're approaching a dock, like this dock coming up right here, I got little things right here, like grass patches. You wanna hit those grass patches first, then go to your man-made stuff. Jig. And my secondary bait right here, soft plastic. I like this when I'm throwing this into pads, short stems of grass, etc. It's really soft, fish grab it, they don't let it go. So you just have to wait an extra second for the hook set. Lean down, feel it, they'll just munch it in their mouth, then hit them. All I'm gonna do here is dissect some of these little spots. Pads, grass, for my little rodent around. Guess what? Now there's even jet skis coming in here. You can tell we're on public lakes, folks, because everybody's here. Everybody and anybody. Big fish. Look at that. Ooh. in the boat. There we go. On the road. See that? A little stick. Look at where he's got it. Whew. That's what you like to get right there. Largemouth on the rodent. Oh, he's probably maybe 3 pounds. We're gonna put him in the live well, see what kind of limit we can get today. And some fat bass in the grass, in the wood, and things away from the public cover, like docks, things like that. We're gonna do the alternate stuff today, see if we can get him. One in there, boy. See, that's what I mean. Just gonna go along. That was nothing. All I saw, seriously, was a small pad about that big. Pitched in, lift up, there's weight. Don't wait, hit. A second ago you saw I had some grass and I said hook. What did I say? I felt the exact same way, but this time was a bass. You seen earlier, there was boats everywhere. Pushed me into little spots that I had to go to find fish and catch fish. Small weed beds, shallow wood, pads, all that kind of stuff. And it's a blast. You catch those kind of big fish that I see on the show, you just have a lot of fun. But you gotta respect them, let them go. And you'll see that we're gonna let these fish go. And get out, saw plastics, favorite rods, reel, and use braid, fluorocarbon, and mono. I use a combination of all three. Utilize all those tools to my advantage to fish these fish. Let's see if we can get a few more. A lot of people up. First weekend of the year, long weekend, extended long weekend. People everywhere. I'm gonna find little spots away from the crowds. And you know what? Getting some good fish because of that. We're just working on the isolated cover, nature's cover. Look at the weed out here. Small weed patches. I see a nice little weed patch up in here. I'm gonna hit the small patches of weed. You never know, man. All of a sudden, it's kapow. Getting them shallow. Wood. Floating rafts. Almost everything. All the natural stuff. Oh, look at this. Just little strands here, but here's the thick stuff right here. There's a big guy. It should be right in there. See if I can pound a big one right here. Look at this one. The size of him. Gotta reach down. Get him. That's what I call great, big, fat bass. Look at that mouth on him. Look at that. That's what we've been waiting for, a giant sitting in weed. Off the bank, away from the docks. Oh, look at the size of that mouth, eh? That's what you call big, fat bass, boy, hiding in the weed, right there. See what I mean? Look at that, she just cut me up too, eh? You get big fish like that, man. Whack, when you set, you know it's big when you can't move. She fought, scrap good. We're gonna take some pictures and let her go. But that's what I keep saying, man, over and over. Sometimes get away where everybody else is fishing. Find your own little spots. And you know what? You can be rewarded like that with the soft plastics. Yeah! I'd say there's not another big fish hiding down in here. Sitting in the weed. That's what I live for, man, fish like that. Small weed clump. Look at that. See that? Guess what's sitting in the weed? I got mama, and then I got little buck bass. Little bucky. Little bucky's gonna go back right away. See that? In the weed, man. Exact same spot. Put him back. Ready, boy? Go on. Rig back up again. Man, those little rodents, eh? Two good fish. And you sometimes I just bit off the tip a little bit. And with those owner's little cross lock, it just slides in like that, turn it around. Here's what I do too, see that? That's all that blue. I like the blue, but it's an Okeechobee color. So it's a little bit of brown, olive, just like that. Sits, push it up. There you go, you're ready to fish. Good weed there, oh boy, weed right here. See what I mean about working other stuff? Tons of boats out here today, pleasure boats, water skiing, swimming, you name it. People are just enjoying summertime in Ontario, summer of 09. So I'm just moving around a bit, get away from all the crowds, trying to still catch some bass. Pretty sure we're doing it. Just a fat bass. This one's coming in the boat like this. Here we go. Sitting in the weed, eh? Good fat bass. Not a giant. But again, out a little weed bed. Look at that, eh? I'm gonna put them in the live well, just for comparison. Take some pictures of the other ones. Put them back, look at that. Sitting in a little weed bed. Wow. Go in there with your friend. See what I mean? Gotta stay back. Throw the weed. Hold on. They do not let go of this bait. I'm telling you. Magic little bait. Magic. Oh, I'm right on top of the spot. Ooh, heart rate's going. It's healthy. Bass fishing. Get your adrenaline going. Look at the weed in here. Weed. Old beaver dam. Something like where we just caught that big fish a little while ago. That's why you get rewarded with big fish. Persistence away from those places that the public is just crowded right in. Let's let those fish go and say thank you for another day. See, that's just a fat little fish. You saw me let some of those go earlier. I know, you're all nice and healthy. Oh yeah, for sure. And this is what we came for. Big fat mama babas. Look at that. Look at that thing. Whoa. That's what I call big fat largies, eh? Look at the head on it. Just a great big fat fish. That's what we came for. Catching these big bass on these public lakes in Southern Ontario. That's what you can get using the soft plastics. Okay, big girl, I'll let you go. You can make somebody else happy. Look at her go. Right on. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next week on Extreme Angler right here on WFN. Boom, get hooked. Fishoflage for the water. Spider thread, cast a web. Lucky strike, more fish fight with lucky strike. Catch us at extremeanglertv.com.